are learning about form, and we are going to make this flat image of an apple, the outline of an apple, become three-dimensional by the way that we color it. And so what I'm going to use today, I'm going to use red and this dark maroon, a little bit of purple, black, and some yellow. But if you only have red, black, and your teacher will be providing you with the white oil pastel, that is fine too. Just use whatever you have on hand. So we will each get one of these apple handouts. And you're about to see a really fun trick. But the way that I'm going to color it, and remember how Miss Santiago says that she doesn't like scribble scrabble? Well, this time, I don't want white spaces, but I am going to color outside of the line because we will be cutting this out later. So I'm going to color up and down, and I had to fold my paper in half that you can see right there. So maybe I'll just cut that real quick so I don't have, maybe I'll just fold it up so that way I don't have that line. But you won't have that problem. And look, I can just color back over it. So look, Miss Santiago's going to color outside of the lines. It's not scribble scrabble because I'm not leaving white spaces, but it is coloring outside of the lines. That way I'm coloring quickly, but covering the entire apple. And now I have it colored, but does it look like a 3D apple just yet? No, not quite. And that's why we need to add our shades and our highlights and even some tones. Okay, so if your crayon box has like a darker red than this color, or if you're deciding to make a yellow apple and you can use orange or greens, you can use some light greens and dark greens. It just depends on your apples. But remember, tones are just different shades of the same color. So what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna take this darker color and I'm gonna kind of run it through the middle. So now I'm making my apple kind of dark in the middle, so it's a medium. It's still the same on each side. So I'm going to choose my left side of my apple, and I'm going to put a little bit of black. But this time, just lightly coloring a little bit of black. And I'll take my red, and I'll go back over. So a little black on this side. And what do you think I want on the other side? So if I have my shade, my tone, and this is all in the lessons we talked about with color, I'm going to take my white, and I'm going to add in that highlight right here on this side. So I'm coloring. So I'm going to have three different colors. I'm going to have like a light, medium, and a dark. And I'm going to go in. You can kind of blend it back in. If you want to add some more coloring on top, I want to go back over that white with my red. Or if I want to go over this black with my purple, I can. And so now I have my apple, and it kind of looks like it's in three stripes, and that's okay if it does, because when we cut it out, we're gonna see, and see, I'm gonna try and blend in a little bit more, that when it's on our piece of paper, it will start to look like a 3D form. And so this is kind of giving us our light, medium, and dark colors. So stay tuned for part 2.